This is a soon-to-be ant queen. It's a female reproductive on her mating flight. And if you look here, you'll see her partner, a male ant, attached and clinging to her even as she lifts off and takes flight. Across the insect world, it's not uncommon to see mating pairs in flight. Even gigantic insects like these blue morpho butterflies are able to stay paired while in the air. In this shot, you can see how just one of them is doing all the wing flapping, impressively carrying the full weight of the other. Now with ants, mating is often more than just a one-on-one interaction. Swarms are common, where a bunch of males, like you see here, will cling to a single female and struggle amongst each other for access. Mating happens only once, so this is the only shot these males will have for passing their genes on. Even with multiple males clinging to her, this ant has three males holding on, flight is still possible. Although, I'm not sure it's easy for them. This female gets into the air, but then quickly arches backward and falls to the ground. There's probably a threshold point where too many males swarming a female makes her flight impossible. This ant crashes back down with four males clinging to her. Surprisingly, all the males stay attached through the crash, and they stay on her while she tries to right herself and scurry off. Over 6 years ago, ants were the first insects I filmed flying in slow motion for this channel. So I thought it'd be interesting to go back to some of that old footage and put it here so we can compare it to how and why I film insects now. Back then, I filmed male ants flying, like this shot of a male Ephenogaster. The next shot is of a male trapjaw ant in the genus Odontomachus. The reason why I first filmed this is because I'd never seen it captured before. Male ants, especially for trapjaw ants, can be shockingly different in appearance from workers. They usually aren't studied as much as workers and queens, so I was just mostly curious to see how they behaved and what they looked like in flight. And honestly, this curiosity is still the main reason why I film insects today. So fast forward 6 years later, and this is more recent footage of male ants taking flight. These are carpenter ants. And if they look to you as oddly proportioned for an ant, you're right. Male ants often have disproportionately smaller heads than workers and queens, as all they need to do is fly out of the colony and find a mate. Here's a direct comparison with a winged female of this species. You can see how much bigger her head is because she'll use it to dig and establish a new colony. This comparison also shows the female to be slower in wing beats, averaging 68 beats per second, while the male here averages 92. When I filmed just a female flying, I got this clip, which shows something interesting. If you watch the hind wings, they aren't flapping like the forewings. In fact, they only seem to move when the forewings bump into them. It seems like they don't have their own powered movement. The failure of the hind wings in this clip might explain why the ant struggles to remain up in the air. Both wings usually work together through this mechanism, a series of hooks lining the top edge of the hind wing. These are called hamuli. And while I knew they attached this way, I didn't realize attaching was the only way the hind wings could move. These shots show how the hind wings start out unattached, and the first few wing beats engage the hind wings from behind so that the hooks can grab on and the two wings can work as a single unit. So for now, those are the new and interesting views of ant flight behavior that I've been able to recently capture. Hopefully, in another few years, maybe less than six this time, I'll have more interesting clips to show. For now, thanks for watching.